na chambele zako Mungu wangu. Nikiwa nazo heshima zote, ninakiri yale uyatendayo. Hakika wewe ni mwema.
Amen, 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 amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
We are coming before the Lord tunaja mbele za Bwana,
yes.
Bringing heshima zote, utukufu wote, na tukisema Mungu wetu,
mm-hmm.
yuaweza na Mungu wetu anastahili.
Mm-hmm.
So welcome today, welcome on board today.
Mm-hmm.
Today is the day that the Lord has made. Remember that we have had some time to talk about our marriage all the way. It's past 10 years, now we are in our 11th year. And we were moved, and we thought that sharing about the mistakes that we have made out there would be very profound and important for our lives and the lives of everyone who is following us,
mm-hmm.
so that we will not repeat the same mistake.
Mm-hmm.
So welcome on board. Welcome on board. This is Marriage thirsty, marriage thirsty. Mm-hmm. The day that we are going to do the other six mistakes that we ever made, that we have made. Some we are trying to overcome, others we have already mastered them, and now we have made it this far. I'm here with my Geno, Pastor Leah. We are excited to host you and to walk together with you. You have always been a blessing throughout, and so we thank the Lord. Today being 6th of August, we are so excited even to come on to come before you, to come to be with you the whole of this evening by the grace of God. For the next like 60 minutes or so, we will be asking questions, answering them, pouring our hearts. We believe that even by yourself, you'll be able to capture something that yes. can make your relationship beautiful, mm-hmm. can make your marriage work, can yes. make even yourself resolve some of the mistakes mm-hmm. That would relate with us. Mm-hmm. And who knows? Today might be your night and your marriage will never be the same again.
Yes.
And so I welcome each one of us on board.
Welcome.
I can see Jenny Mombi there saying, Wapi tuko hapa. Mm-hmm. I can see Mima Wango is saying tuned. I can also see Phyllis David there saying waiting. Yes. I can see Terry Kimani there saying tuned in kabisa. Mm-hmm. And so all of us, remember we are also live at Pastor Joseph Kinyanjui's YouTube page. And so both pages are working.
Yes.
And so come on board, call somebody. Mm-hmm. And because before we make the prayer, because we want to begin with the Lord, mm-hmm. I want you to answer this prayer. Answer for me this prayer. This is not the prayer to the Lord. Mm-hmm. This is the prayer to you. What is the prayer to them?
They share the video.
Yes.
So that all other people will be blessed and will be part of this program. So kindly, before we pray, the prayer first is you share the video.
So please share, answer that prayer for us. Mm-hmm. You know, call your friend.
Invite your friend.
You know, share this video. Share this video with other people in the groups that you are a member,
yes.
or even if you are not a member, just force yourself in there.
Yeah.
You never know. This good thing could mm-hmm. be the very
yes.
Answer that these people have been looking for.
Yes.
It could be the very need that they
yes.
had,
yes.
and they will count you amongst their angels
mm-hmm.
That you came in,
yes.
you helped them and mm-hmm. they were able to resolve their challenges,
yes.
and you made their lives happy once again.
Yes.
So tonight, share it. Na tuingie. Naomba, our boy Gracie, all the way from Bahrain, mm-hmm. anasema watching. Naona mwingine anajita Wambo Gracious. Tuko na Wambo Gracie from Bahrain.
Mm-hmm.
We have another one today called Wambo Gracious.
Yes.
Anasema tuned from Deya Nyataragi. Lea Gitao, I can see you. Unasema niko ndani.
Mm-hmm.
Karo Dege, anasema niko tuned.
Yes.
And so welcome each other.
Sana.
Welcome others, friends, come on board,
mm-hmm.
ili tukaweze kushiriki pamoja katika
yes.
kuongereshana,
yes.
kujibizana.
Mm-hmm.
We told you that this
kusaidiana.
Is kusaidiana.
Yes.
This is our month of anniversary.
Yes.
The Lord joined us together in this new month.
Mm-hmm.
And so we are pouring our hearts. We are sharing ourselves with you.
Yes.
And we want you to learn from our mistakes
mm-hmm.
so that you don't repeat the same
mistake.
We have learned from mm-hmm. it.
Mm-hmm.
And they say that experience is the best teacher. But sometimes bitter experiences,
mm-hmm.
some experiences are so expensive mm-hmm. that you don't want to go through them.
Yes.
Na kwa sababu sisi tumepitia,
mm-hmm.
kwa nini wewe upitie na tuko hapa usome na sisi,
mm-hmm.
and we are willing to open our hearts, our minds, and share together with us.
So, and those mistakes and also,
yeah,
they become big problems.
Yes.
And they cause challenges, they cause divorce, they cause separation.
Yes.
They are not solved when
yes,
they arise.
For sure.
Yeah.
And so as also we come before to you to share with us,
mm-hmm.
remember that we are also in our fasting of 3 days.
Mm-hmm.
We started our fasting yesterday. This is our second day. We are closing tomorrow midnight.
Mm-hmm.
Na kwa hivyo tutaomba, tutaendelea kuomba,
mm-hmm.
na ninajua kuna mahitaji uko nayo, kutufuata pale, tutaweza kukuombea, na tunaamini ya kwamba Mungu atakubariki. So
yes.
let's make a prayer as we begin the program
oh, yes,
of our
Jesus,
Father and our
name
God
Lord,
in the name
God.
Of Jesus. We come before you tonight in the name of Jesus. Almighty Redeemer, we've never come before the lens here tonight by ourselves. But every evening, oh God, every Tuesday evening, every Thursday evening, whenever you've brought us to these beautiful people, you have already, oh God, invested and loaded us with the content that they require in their lives, oh God. Ours, oh God, is to pray that we shall be found faithful by you, oh God, even to deliver what you have entrusted with us. We are speaking to that marriage out there that it is becoming better and better in the name of the Lord. We are speaking to that relationship out there that it is becoming better and blessed of the Lord. We are speaking in the lives of the singles that they are getting blessed of the Lord, that even in the in the problems, whatever they are going through and they require answers, you are coming through in the mighty name of the Lord. My Father, we speak and we pray that whatever it is you want us to share with your people tonight, that it will be helpful for their lives, even God, as you have helped us to overcome these mistakes in our 11 years. We are so grateful as we approach the day on 8th of August when we celebrate 11 years of God's faithfulness in our relationship. God, take the preeminence now. Lead us in the entire program and bless us as you bless your people. Hallelujah. This is our humble prayer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. 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 May the Lord God bless you. Amen. Thank you even for joining us. I can see Shiko Wawili saying tuned. I can see Sarah Mogwe saying Danny Sana from Vika. I can see Koi Prisika anasema niko tuned.
Karibuni sana.
Karibuni sana. And today is the day. And as always, I want to start with the word of the Lord being our foundation. The Bible says in Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 11, he has made everything beautiful in its time. He has made everything beautiful in its time. And so tonight we are saying that marriage is made beautiful by God. And God has made life beautiful, that even your relationship is made beautiful. Your life as a single is meant to be beautiful. And whenever we come before you, we are coming to tell you that it's gonna be beautiful. It will become beautiful. Because the beautifier is with us. He is the one who makes relationships work. Na ndiye ametusaidia katika makosa ambayo tumefanya katika ndoa. Na ndio maana leo tuko na furaha, tuko na smile on our faces, telling you it is possible to make it, and you will make it kwa sababu Mungu ni mwaminifu. So welcome on board. This is the chance now to give my Geno an opportunity to say hi and also to welcome you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Our viewers, I want to greet you in Jesus' name.
Yes.
I know the Lord has been good to you, the same He has been good to me, and I'm so excited this evening to come to you born again, telling you that mistakes we make, they are always there to make us improve in our marriages. So welcome and share the video so that all of us may be taught together. And I know the beautifier is going to beautify our marriages in Jesus' name. So welcome, and kindly you can post your question, whatever you want to ask, kindly don't fear. We are here to help each other because marriage has to work.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
And so we are saying it will work for you.
Yes.
It is working for us. Mm-hmm. By the grace of God, even tomorrow it will work.
Yes.
And so yours, by the grace of God, it will work. Your relationship will function. Mm-hmm. You will know which is the kind of relationship that you should be in, how to handle it, how even to detect a toxic relationship, how to deal with it, and how to find yourself found, blessed in a certain arrangement, how to find yourself the beneficiary and not the loser in any particular arrangement. Na kwa hivyo inawezekana. I can
possible.
See Miriam Pato there, Mukunga saying tuned, and Fiorella Julie saying amen.
Karibuni sana.
Last time when we were here, we shared 5 serious mistakes that we made.
Yes.
One of them was about communication.
Mm-hmm.
We didn't know the mind of each other.
Yeah.
We didn't know how to respond.
The tone.
The tone, how to react, or how to respond. respond and how to action ourselves in the midst of talking or even the body language. We didn't know how to interpret a different thing. And so we were seriously in a mess. The other thing that we talked about is about money, that I could buy whatever I want. Sometimes I would lie, like I have been purchased by my sister.
You don't want to tell the truth that you bought.
Yeah, because I knew the reaction of my wife will not be something that I want to go with tomorrow and the other day. Mm-hmm. The other thing was our inability to handle uncertainty.
We
told you about our beautiful, blessed angel.
Yeah,
how she came and we were like, oh gosh,
why
has she come? And today, she is the greatest joy of our relationship. Mm-hmm. The last born is usually that little girl who is there to welcome us in the house and the last one talking English. Currently, she is speaking very good English that is upside down. And we are happy to hear an upside down English. Mm-hmm. And also, we talked about anger.
Mm-hmm.
You know, being unable to deal with anger. Mm-hmm. When you're angry, you
just keep quiet.
Yes. You want everything, you nag, you want everyone to know you are angry. It's like even you want the thermos to know the things in the dishes to understand the
bedroom
that you are so angry. We didn't know how to handle our anger. We threw tantrums to each other, but by the grace of God, we are able to overcome that.
Yes.
Even about being unthankful.
Mm-hmm.
The men, we want to do what we are supposed to do, but our wives must appreciate.
Mm-hmm.
And so even if I am supposed to pay the rent, I want to, when I bring that receipt that I have paid the rent, I want my wife, my Genoa, to say, wow, you have tried.
It's your responsibility.
And so she used to say, it is your responsibility. Why do you expect me? And so whenever she cooks, I would take revenge and not say anything about
you can imagine.
And so we lived such kind of a life. It was a mess.
Nagging.
And we were there just like that. Those were the five serious mistakes that we ever made.
Mm-hmm.
And so today, what is that next mistake that we have done and we have learned from?
And it was like a problem.
Yes.
The other mistake that we learned, there are so many, but we are going to discuss the 11.
Yes.
The 11 ones, because we are celebrating 11 years in marriage.
Mm-hmm.
The other one is about disorganization.
Mm-hmm.
And this goes with men.
Mm-hmm.
Although even there are those ladies that are disorganized, but this is how it used to happen.
Mm.
Like my Jeno anatoa socks. Anaweka tu anywhere.
Uh-huh.
Like anatoka bed anaachanisha tu, you know. Uh-huh. And I'm like, okay, are you not a grown up? Why are you doing this?
Yes.
You need to think that even me, I get tired. I justifying myself.
Yes.
That it is not only me who need to make the bed. It is not only me who is supposed even to put the socks where I'm supposed to be.
Mm.
And at that time, ziko chafu.
Mm.
Sasa guo akitoa, the same case applies to me. Nikitoka job, I'm tired. Narusha bag wherever I want.
Mm-hmm.
So all those disorganizations, they were causing conflict. Mm-hmm. We could keep on blaming each other. Unajua nimechoka, hata wewe huwezi tadika bed, hasa wewe huwezi weka guo chafu mahali zinastahili kuwekwa. All those disorganizations, it could even cause because you are not following the instructions, you are not doing what you are supposed to do. And let me tell you, for us to make it work for us, this is what we did. We now to Kasema, this is what we are going to do. We introduce a basket, unaweka nguo chafu. We introduce a drawer where the socks and other things are supposed to be kept. So if you fail to do that, now you are questionable.
And so in this disorganization, for me, I think making the bed is not a big deal, because you just jump into the bed and you hit with your leg. you know, there is a way that we are professionally, men are professionally made to make the bed. You throw your leg, and that would make my wife mad, you know.
Because I want it to be done well,
you know. Organized. She is a perfectionist in that area, that when I put off my shoes, I have to carry them and put them where they are supposed to be, my socks, my handkerchief, even when I'm taking off my jacket, I have to go and hang it where it is supposed to be. And so for me, it was not a big deal, because as long as the shoe imefika kwa mlango, as long as your jacket haiko nje na hakuna mvua, sasa sikae tu hapo. And so this disorganization, it could become a source of conflict every time. Unaachia nguo nani hapo? And so for me, I would hear like she is saying, unafikiria you have someone you have employed in this house, especially
to be doing that for you.
Especially when we didn't even have children. Now wait, when the first kid came, and so everyone, she is busy with the kid, and I am here. The shoes and the socks are out there, and so we are there. We are out. The disorganization was a serious mess. It was a mistake.
It could even make me angry. Because you are not following rules.
Yes.
You're not doing what you are supposed to do. What I'm instructing you to do, you are not doing it.
Yes.
So it's like, I'm mad. I don't want things to go this way. I want the socks to be here.
Yes.
I want you to know that this is where the trouser is supposed to be kept. But can you imagine? He did contrary. He used to do it contrary.
And the other confusion was, tomorrow, I really need the belt that I had yesterday. I really need that pair of shoes. Maybe I want to polish, but you can't find one shoe of the pair. And so this
disorganization,
you know, everything is made that, you know, it is scattered all over. And so I'm in a hurry. I'm looking for the belt. And now my Geno here is saying, okay, it is what you did. Go and look for it would hype my anger, and I'm feeling I want to throw some few words that are not very biblical. And so I would find myself, you know, insulting, like sounding crazy, and I would leave the house very angry because of disorganization. But later on, out of the experience, I was able to learn that I need to be a bit organized.
Yes.
I need to know where to keep the shoes. I need to know that after using a cup or any dish, I need to take it back to where it is supposed to be. In fact, I learned that I can also even get to kitchen and find that the used dishes are lying there, and I can get them into the sink and wash them, and she would appreciate that. I learned something from it. The disorganization, it led me to becoming organized and also being in a position to participate to make the house be
organized.
A neat place to be. And so we learned that disorganization. And I know that some of us have gone through the same. Learn from it.
It is workable.
Be organized. Especially, I would say this, that when a man gets into a house that is disorganized, unakutanga anakuwa put off. I can tell you that even the trap that mipango ya kando inafanya kule inje ni kuorganize everything.
Yes.
Ili mwanaume akiingia pale, anaona hangers iko pale, mahali pa kuweka viatu iko pale.
On the table in our kitchen, even in the bedroom, men like organization. So if yourself you are not organized, how will your man? Because us ladies, we are the ones who are supposed to teach this man to be organized. Because I'm the one who was insisting, lazima ifanyike. Lazima organization ikuwe. So if now he has the responsibility of asking the children, mumecheza the whole day. Why are the toys so scattered in the house? So they know wakisikia tu mlango hivi, wanakimbia kuchukua the toys, kuziweka where they are supposed to be kept. Because already we got the solution. The solution was, learn from this, be doing this. And I can assure you, since that time, no fight.
No fight.
Organization.
And by the way, when you are messy in terms of organization, and the kids come, they don't come to make things easier.
Actually, they make them
worse. House because of the toys, because of how they are playing and they're irresponsible. You might find your house looking very crazy. And so kuna hata watu wengine unakuta mpaka diapers imetapakaa everywhere. And you still want to enjoy life and enjoy your marriage? No, haifanyi kazi namna hiyo. So the gentleman learn how to keep things. The wives out there learn how to keep things.
Keep things organized.
Organized. Yeah. I can see David right down there saying, your reception is very clear tonight. Thank you, Pasin. I can see Fiola Julie saying, Joan is the acting last born, Ya Mungu ni mengi. I can see Jose Washira saying tuned. I can see Shiko Wawiri saying mimi nakasirikanga mpaka ikifika Colgate katikati hapo kwa socks. I gave up. Terry Kimani saying I'm listening very well and ready to learn through. Gilbert Langat saying haha hapo kwa spreading bed wanaume. But we need to pull up our socks. So your design is coming. I can see Mimi Wangoi saying congratulations, dear ones. And I can see Gil Palangat saying that side ya kuosha vyombo. No. It is responsibility of women. I just want to tell you, Langat, do you want to be romantic in your house?
Yeah.
Just get there into the sink and wash. Do some few dishes there.
Or even you sit in the kitchen as the wife does.
Yeah, give company.
It's romantic.
Yeah, it is.
You give the company.
Did you hear that?
Yeah, it's romantic. Not only sitting on the table room waiting to watch the TV.
Yes.
Watching all the stations.
Yes.
It is always good to be in the kitchen.
Yes.
Even if you are giving stories as your wife is doing something else.
You can even be tickling there. Yeah. You're doing like this.
Yeah.
It's a bit romantic there. So and with that goal that we have been able to learn from there. The other mistake that we did and that really did cost us some amount of money was called wrong investment. Wrong investment. We just jumped into investing without consultation. We didn't care. In fact, we said investment as
I think you are driven by what you are going through.
Yeah.
By luck. As we were talking about the enemies of marriage.
Yes.
Luck was one of it.
Yes.
So as getting into wrong investment, we thought that if we do this, we'll be rich.
Yeah.
But I can assure you, it drained us.
It did.
It drained us.
Seriously.
Because I remember,
we
started with the mushroom.
Yes.
Training of mushroom. You can imagine where I was going for training.
Mm.
From Kenoa, those that know Kenoa, to Kenyatta University.
Yes.
That's where I used to go. Yes. And at 8, I was supposed to be in class.
Yes.
And I had a small baby.
Yes.
Bednaida, our firstborn girl. Yes. You can imagine going there very early. I could leave the house at 5 in the morning. And we paid for me to go and be taught on how I can grow mushroom.
Mm.
And I was paying for that class because I went for 1 month.
Mm.
But you know what? I even went ahead looking for houses because of mushrooms are grown in houses.
Mm.
Actually, I remember tulizunguka sana, these are our gig, and we got the house. But you know what?
Yeah, those are, you know, we made it wrong because we didn't do enough research to understand how valid is this particular kind of investment. Who are the people farming mushrooms?
Yes.
We just got an idea. Somebody told us, by the way, you guys, you can try mushroom. Yeah. Not many people have invested in mushroom. Mm-hmm. And 1 kg of mushroom is going this much. You can sell to the big
and
hotels.
And we thought of becoming rich.
We did not do our homework.
Yes.
And so I just asked my Geno here, why can't you go to school and study mushroom at JQUAT? And so I paid. She graduated, she got her certificate, we came, we went for the seeds, but I'm telling you, at the end of the day, the temperatures, the marashi,
you are not even able to know.
We didn't understand anything, and so we had our money sink.
Yeah.
It was washed down the drain. Yeah. The second investment was this guy who just looked at the pastor and said, "Pastor looks like he has some investment.
Gonna see the sun,
and so we can do some business on chicken." And so I went to my account. I withdrew my bunch of money. I came out with it. I gave the guy. The guy took the cash.
Yeah.
And so I didn't know that rearing chicken, it would take the houses. It would take an employee.
Yeah.
It would take the market.
Mm-hmm.
It would take the veterinary office. I didn't understand. We did not do background studying about whatever we were getting into. And so another amount of money sunk.
Yes.
The third sinking, na musitu chekele, kwa sababu tumetoka mbali. Ujue hatukuwa nazo, lakini zinazidi kuzama.
Zinazidi kuzama.
We are newly married. We are just young
and
in
these are two people trying to make life work.
And you can imagine, when I invested in chicken, nilikuwa peke yangu.
Yeah.
Mimi si kumuhusisha. Mimi nienda tu ni excitement. Ikanifanya niende nichukue pesa niweke. Now you can imagine in my house. Pesa nimepoteza. My jeno wako hapa anasema ulipoteza pesa aje, bona huku niuliza, bona huku nihusisha.
Blames.
And so it was very tough for
now
us.
Now he came and now he was telling me, you know what? You need it to go be going there very early in the morning at six
to look after,
those chicken,
because it's partnership.
It is partnership.
Yes.
And both of you, the wife of that guy and me, we have to work together and look for market.
Yes.
So who am I not to obey?
You remember,
I was not working.
We remember we did not do some thorough investigation, even about the chicken coop, how we are going to have that house.
Yeah.
And so one night, the heavens, the clouds opened.
Yeah.
The floods came.
Kept.
They went through the house. And our chicken, all of them, they turned to ducks.
Yeah.
They started swimming. And they were layers. Can you imagine?
It was
our money was washed away. Then we did another investment. I think we did a shop.
Yeah.
Along
Mari Show. Oh my goodness, we have come from far.
I was a pastor.
Yeah.
The church I worked for, they did not allow pastors to invest
or
to do a shop.
Yeah.
And so I would get into the shop, then I would hide. I had put tint kind of windows so that when I can see you from the other end, you can't see me.
Yeah.
And so if a church member came by, I would just hide behind the mirrors, and she or he would go knowing that the seller is not there, the shopkeeper is not around. But it was another wrong investment because we didn't have time for it.
Yeah.
We didn't know what is selling in the area.
Mm-hmm.
We didn't know that it can't match what we do.
Yeah.
We are investing wrongly.
Mm-hmm.
And so we
lost. Without even advice, without even doing researches.
Yes.
Because of this spirit, this spirit of lack, this spirit of poverty,
yes.
You think that I have to be like so and so.
Mm-hmm.
I have to be working. I'm not supposed to sit. I am not supposed to be idle.
Yes.
So even you don't even have time to do the research.
Yes.
You get into the business. You think now it's well.
Uh-huh.
My goodness, it's not.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But it taught us that we were doing this for the sake of our family.
Yes.
So it taught us that when you want to do something, research is the key.
Yes.
And involve people that surely they have been into those kinds of business that they can be able to advise.
Yeah.
So even if we kept on blaming each other, we came to realize that it is always good to try something and stand and say, okay, we tried this and this and this. It did not work. Yeah.
For sure. So if you're out there, what we can advise you, as I agree with my Geno here, is that you need to talk, you need to do your background study, you need to visit a financial consultant or a person who have been out there in the business, who can advise you to study the market, to understand what you are capable of doing, and even how to grow your business.
Mm-hmm.
But don't enter into wrong investment.
Yes.
Out of excitement, you get into business, you are just advised by somebody that I can come in and manage your business. Yes, I'm telling you, during my chicken investment, that guy told me I am going to manage this particular investment. I didn't know that it will get to a point whereby even my Genoa will be forced to rise up early in the morning to go and give the chicken water.
Yeah.
I didn't foresee. I thought he will manage everything. And so, my friend out there, if you are doing business, especially in a relationship, or you are doing a business alone, make sure that you do your homework well. Understand what are your capabilities, what are your areas of production and progress, so that you can measure it.
And sit, discuss what you want to do.
Yes.
Because my general here, he went ahead doing it with a friend.
Mm.
We thought that that friend will help us.
Mm.
But you know what? At the end of it all,
ulienda
nini nyumbani, one tray of eggs.
Yes. Can you imagine investing tens of thousands?
Yeah. One tray of eggs.
One tray is 30 eggs.
Yeah.
30 eggs. Hata kulingana na vile nilikasirika ni kama hazikufika. Unakutana na rafiki wa barabara unamgonga matube tano.
Mm-hmm.
Unaenda unagonga mwingine tano. Kwa sababu ya you can't imagine how that money went down the drain.
Mm-hmm.
But take care that you are not getting your relationship or your marriage or your money into such a serious mess.
Mm-hmm.
I can see Terry Kimani there saying, ha ha, ya quails. I meant to compose those guys who invested in quails.
Yes.
I'm Koi Prisika is just laughing there, talking
investment.
About chicken.
Yeah.
Wabu Gracie saying, thanks, I'm here. Edina Gemu, welcome, saying, tuned. Ebi Mwesh saying, hapo kwa investment, most people lose a lot of money trying their luck. May God help us.
Mm-hmm.
And Fiola Julie saying, hapo kwa investment, law especially lad. Kinya Kahora. Lucy Nyambula saying, listening. And she is also saying there, she is complimenting mom here, saying, mama looking beautiful. Oh, and so wrong investment was another mistake, serious mistake that we ever made.
Yes.
And I can tell you, the shakeups that we went through when I lost that money, they can be the cause of your divorce.
Yes.
They can cause separation. They can cause even mistrust, and it can cause so many things.
Hatred.
You don't trust your partner anymore.
There is no trust.
Yes.
There is no even now talking.
Yes.
There is now anger, pride, all those.
Yes. And in that wrong investment, make sure that your business partner is a trusted partner.
Yes.
I dealt with person who had issues with trust.
Mm.
And so aliponiongeresha mambo ma ayo yote akiwa my senior, I opted to trust even more than my wife. I didn't involve my wife. And so I'm telling you, even you, the single guys, if you are going to partner with anybody, angalia the track record, trust ya huyo mtu. And that will help you determine and make sure that your investment is not just a mere risk.
Yes.
Make sure you are taking a calculated kind of a risk.
Yes.
But usiingie tu kwa risk useme ati unajua biashara ni kubahatisha. Hapana, do not bahatisha if you could have done something better. So
that's
wrong
good.
Investment, take care of it.
And
the other mistake is BLAMES,
blames.
Yes.
Not accepting that you have made a mistake. Those are conflict management. Like if I am the one who has not done the bed, I couldn't accept Sio Mimi and him too. It's like now we are kuru. No one is willing to accept that surely I have done this.
Yes.
And because I have done this, what I'm supposed to do is to ask for forgiveness.
Mm.
And I don't think we used to even to apologize.
Yes.
Because of that pride.
Mm-hmm.
Because in us, we are like, okay, so we are all grown up. Why are you not doing what you're supposed to do? Why are you doing this? And maybe it is something that we could have solved.
Mm-hmm.
But you know what? We kept blaming. Niwewe ulifanya, niwewe ulienda, like whatever happened with the long investment, Now I kept blaming my general here.
Yes.
And it was not for him. It was for the good of our family.
Uh-huh.
You see?
Yeah.
But I kept blaming. Nuele ulijingiza. Nuele uliamini huyo mtu. You see the brains not accepting it has been done imetendeka.
Yes.
Na kwa sababu imetendeka, what are we supposed to go?
Mm-hmm.
We move forward.
Yes.
But that was not the case.
Mm-hmm.
We kept blaming. Even in the house. Niwewe huja kubuka kununua maziwa. Niwewe huja kubuka kununuria mtoto daipa. You see, those brains.
Yes.
No one could accept the mistake. And when the brains comes in, what happened? I always say there is anger.
Yes.
No communication.
Yes.
Sasa, that marriage ikona baridi.
Yes.
That relationship ikona baridi. Even you fear asking your spouse a question because you don't know how he is going to respond.
Yes.
Or how I'm going to respond.
Oh, yes. Actually so, not responding,
yeah,
but reacting.
Reacting.
Yes.
He did not know how I'm going to react because I'm angry. Because I thought I'm an angel. You see, I sitaki si mimi hastahili kunikosea.
Yes.
Na mimi si stahili kumkosea. You can imagine.
Mm.
Now it's like pull and push.
Yes.
Pull and push. But what happened?
Yes.
Okay, we realized we are not going anywhere.
Mm-hmm.
What are we supposed to do now?
Yes.
It is always good to have dates and catch-ups.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And that really helped us.
Yes.
D-A-T-E-S.
Yes.
Dates.
Underline.
The word date.
Holding it.
Yes.
That is what we do.
Exactly.
Making meetings.
Yes.
Discussing on that particular
exactly.
issue.
Exactly.
It helps you.
And coming up with a solution.
For sure.
And I always say not in the house because in the house the children are there, they will disturb
you.
Utasema mimi nimechoka acha nikara.
And not a date that takes forever.
No.
You can just go out for lunch and you say this lunch is attached to a certain agenda.
Yes.
We have had this discussion.
Mm-hmm.
We have had this commotion.
Mm-hmm.
We have had this difference.
Mm-hmm.
So we want to sort things out. But this one,
mm-hmm.
it must take both of you.
Mm-hmm.
I am willing to hear my mistakes,
yes.
and she's willing
yes.
To go with it and to discuss with me
mm-hmm.
how we can make ourselves
yeah.
better. And so this one helped us.
Mm-hmm.
The blames, shifting blames,
mm-hmm.
pointing fingers.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, once you start blaming your partner,
mm-hmm.
everything else itaenda tu hivyo.
Yeah.
Ata akienda akute ya kwamba dawa ya meno imeondolewa mahali ilipo. Anasema, I knew. You are very yeah. so a nice person.
Utatoa tu.
Yeah, I knew.
Itaisha na utasema.
Utasema. And so, na mimi ninamgoja pande ingine, ninamuambia, you see, I knew you are never cooking food on time.
Mm-hmm.
You are never prepared for anything. I knew.
Mm-hmm.
I knew.
Mm-hmm.
Those blames.
Yeah.
And we know we are talking with people right now.
Mm-hmm.
Ambao ata doa yao hamuongereshani kwa sababu ya blame.
Na blames.
Ati wewe uliniacha.
Mm-hmm.
Na huyu mwingine anasema ulilala na nilikuambia uset alarm.
Mm-hmm.
Those blames, they don't make a relationship better.
Yes.
Those blames, they destroy
the effect.
Yes.
Yeah. Because when you keep blaming each other,
mm-hmm.
you don't solve anything.
Yeah.
It will get to a point where by now you start shouting to each other.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because you don't accept that I have made a mistake.
Yes.
This is what I have done.
Uh-huh.
Kindly forgive me.
Yes.
You are not even willing to say sorry.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You are not even willing.
Yes.
To accept that surely I have made this mistake.
Yes.
And we say it. Pride is the only thing that can cause you not even to say sorry.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Pride is the only enemy in marriage that can cause you not to accept your mistake.
Yes. Yes.
But if you swallow your pride,
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
and if you really value your relationship, because we say it, saying sorry, it doesn't mean that you have made a mistake.
Yes.
No, because you value your relationship, now you are very fast to say sorry.
Mm.
You accept your mistake for you to be able to move forward.
Yes.
Yeah.
And so blame is such a serious mistake.
Yes.
It can graduate into an attitude.
Mm-hmm.
It can even
to hatred to
go on to become something worse like hatred.
Yeah.
Like a catch every time you there is fear within yourself.
Yeah.
You're saying, will I do this and then I'll be like shouted
yeah.
at?
Mm-hmm.
Will I do this and then it will not do well with my wife or my husband? So you must understand about blaming each other,
mm-hmm.
so that you are able to solve whatever it is that your marriage or your relationship is going through.
Yes.
Make sure that you don't blame each other.
Yes.
If you are blaming each other, sort it out.
Yeah.
Sort it
and swallow
out
your pride.
And swallow your pride.
Because it is only pride,
yes,
that make relationship,
yes,
that make couples to mm-hmm. keep blaming
yes.
each other.
Mm-hmm.
And it's only pride.
Yeah.
Not anything else. Because
yes.
if I'm not proud,
mm-hmm.
what is so hard to say sorry?
Mm-hmm.
What is so hard to accept
yeah.
my
mm-hmm.
mistake? But
mm-hmm.
I want to win.
Mm-hmm.
I want to be seen a winner.
Yes, yeah. yes. And so I can see there, Shiko Jose saying, hapo kwa investment, men need like 1 week seminar. yeah, wanaume unajua ni kuwekelea.
Yeah.
Tunawekelea tu, ati ni deal
imani.
Ati wanaume ni kujaribu, mm-hmm. wanaume ni kutake risk. Hapana, yeah. you got married. Please, your partner there is a helper, a companion. You, both of you, you wish each other well. And so, as we have not done a mistake of competition, mm-hmm. but when you start competing
with each other,
that is where
mm-hmm.
you breed and you bring about this kind of wrong investment.
Yes.
And Terry Kimani is saying, blame games, hapo. And I can see Fiorella Jury saying, haya, apologies. Ni kitu ya maana sana. It will cost you zero.
Yeah.
to tell your wife or your husband, I'm sorry. I can see Peter Shaw saying great teachings there. I pray that they are great teachings. Phyllis David saying date. Ah, ni date. D-A-D-E-T. Hiyo ni dawa ya marriage
yeah.
na uhusiano. And Shiko Jose saying wapi volume ya hapo kwa date. Dio hiyo ninaongeza tu.
Mm-hmm.
Mary Waboy saying we appreciate for your counseling. And Annie Wadai. Anasema hapo kwa blames, aki God, help me. So, wacha tufungie hapo. That's a serious mistake.
Yeah.
Lakini Mungu ametusaidia.
Mm.
On Saturday 8th, we are celebrating our 11 years
yes.
in marriage.
Yes.
And so we thank the Lord.
And the God has been so faithful.
So beautiful.
It is
so beautiful.
A matter of accepting
yeah.
that we are not angels.
Yes.
We make mistakes.
Yes.
And when we make mistakes,
mm-hmm.
it is not bad to make mistake. It is okay,
yes.
especially in a relationship,
yes.
to make a mistake.
Yes.
But the thing is, are you willing to work together to overcome those mistakes?
Those mistakes. This is why we are discussing
that is the key
here.
Thing, yeah.
And so the other mistake that we did was taking each other for a ride, for granted.
Yeah.
and so I would just go out there and I wouldn't bother calling.
Yeah.
Ninaenda kwa my sister, mimi ninakaa tu.
Sini bibi yangu tu.
Mpaka ninakula sapa pale.
Yeah.
My wife is in the house, she is preparing herself to receive the prince or the king.
The king of the house.
And so she is excited, it's on a weekend,
yeah.
we want to have chicken or do something like that. You know, she's just making everything beautiful in the kitchen. But myself, mimi niko huko kwa my sister, nishakula ugali. Sasa ninaangalia tu time na kwa sababu it's like 20 minutes drive. Sasa sina shida nikifika
yeah.
tu kwa nyumba si nikulala.
Na sahi maji paka nimekocha, nimelala hapa kwa kiti.
Yes.
You cannot even
so,
go to bed.
I'm not giving a call. I'm not texting.
No explanation.
Yeah. And so,
yeah.
si ninaenda tu nyumbani na nilikuoa. and so taking each other for
granted.
It really messed us.
Yeah. Think it's your responsibility
yeah.
because now we are married.
Yes.
We trust each other. Unaenda.
Yes.
The same case applies to me.
Yes.
I could go to work
and
work
by the way,
even for long hours.
I would see you calling me.
Yeah.
You are at home. You are calling me. I'm at my sister's place. Staki kuchukua simu nikuambia niko wapi because what is the big deal? Nitakukall to kimalizana.
Yeah.
Nitakukall to taking
you
each other.
Come to explain.
Yeah. Sijui nyinyi kama mwai kuchukuliwa
for
kimzaa. Yani ile tu naweza sema tu kwa Shen kuchukuliwa wana.
And you know what? taking each other for granted.
Yes.
You are sitting on the table room,
yes.
but the Geno is yes. very busy with the phone.
Uh-huh.
Not talking.
Yes.
And you are just there, you are thinking, okay,
yes. Together but very far.
Yeah, together but you are very far.
Yes.
Because no communication, no talking.
Yes.
Jeno is here with, busy with the phone.
Yes.
Myself, I'm busy with the phone. I want to make sure that if, because tomorrow I'm going to work,
yes,
everything has to be okay. Nimekumbuka
kuna siku uliniongelesha vibaya.
Yeah.
Mpaka nika feel so guilty. Karibu nivunje hiyo phone. Na ninajua nilizima hiyo phone for like 2 days.
Yeah.
That's what it can cost you.
Yeah.
You know, nikazima simu because I'm feeling like I'm so guilty.
Yeah.
I took my wife for granted. Kwa sababu ya yale maneno. Sijui nyinyi kama mwai rushiwa maneno na your wives. Mimi sijui kama nimewai rusha maneno kwa. Wewe diyo umewai nirushia ama?
Yata wewe nirushia.
Unajua sijui kama wanaume mbuko hapo mzeme.
Kulipisha kisazi.
Wakati unarushiwa neno na madam na mna hii inachomanga.
Yeah.
Inaibale karo kama mshale.
The eye of a dark tuipo hapa.
Yes.
Unai nini kabisa.
Yes.
Unayamusha kabisa.
Yes.
Jeno anasikia, oh my goodness.
Yes.
Where will I go?
Yeah.
Let me go out and walk. you are taking me for granted.
Let me hear men speak there. Where are you, Akina Mbongai, Akina Charles? Where are you? I can't see you. I can see Gilbert Langat there saying swallowing a pride in men is like looking for formula for revenue sharing. Oh my. I think that's a whole yeah. lesson that you need to take into account and learn. Sarah Mo was saying, blames simemaliza maboma aki. Melian Moa is saying, great job. I miss your teachings in Kwifanga. Thank you. That program will be coming back. I know, Melian, you started following me in Kameme TV for some several years. Fiolela Julie saying, haki hapo kwa wak, lea ololo. I remember quarreling with you. Terry Kemani say they walolo waja tu. Taking each other for granted.
Yes. You don't know how to go home.
Yeah.
It's like it's your and this is where we make the mistake.
Yeah.
We think that if you don't excuse yourself from work,
yes,
the time that you're supposed to leave the office, you lose the job.
Yes.
But you know what? You can lose the job
and
look for another job.
Mm.
But for your husband and your wife,
you
can't
keep
on. Kumweka chini, unachukua mwingine. And when I came to realize, okay, okay, I am not serious. I could even go to work up to 12.
Yeah.
In the morning.
Mm-hmm.
And you have a family, you have small kids. And you're like, okay, unangangana usifutwe.
Yeah.
Na bwanako akienda, na bibi yako akienda.
Yes.
And this way I came to learn that, oh my goodness, I won't take family for granted. Because I'm employed doesn't mean that I work, I give it all, I forget that I have a family.
Yes.
And that's what used to happen.
Yeah.
When I come in home, my general here, amekasirika na shida. Now, what kind of a job is this?
And you know, the work of complimenting each other is about being present, is about talking and connecting, is about being there to do something together.
Yeah.
And so when you take your wife for granted, when you take your husband for granted, then you are allowing so many things that would separate you to have a place. You are creating a vacuum inside your relationship.
Yeah.
And marriages should be airtight. Mm-hmm. Relationships should be airtight.
Yes.
You must keep connecting, keep coming together,
yes,
keep fighting battles
together. The battles together. But keep communicating, keep solving the mistakes when they realize.
Yeah, like you are on a phone call.
Yeah.
Your wife is looking at you saying, I want you to help with something. And you continue on that long call.
And you are in the same car. You are driving.
Yes.
And you are both of you in the car.
Yeah.
Two of you.
Yeah.
You are busy with your phone.
Yeah. You can't excuse yourself
for a minute
for your
this
wife.
This is my wife.
And
mazoea, kwa sababu now you got married, ulipata kile ulikuwa unataka.
Yes.
And remember, wakati watu wanaoana, upendo unakuanga juu sana.
Yes.
What happens, inafika mahali upendo unaisha.
Mm-hmm.
Ama upendo unafika mahali, it becomes bitter.
Yes.
Ni kuzoeana, and when you don't realize, ya kwamba sasa, we need to sit and be talking. We need to come against, we need to rebuke the spirit of kuzoeana.
Yes.
Kwa sababu watu wakizoeana, you develop a don't care attitude.
Uh-huh.
And when you develop a don't care attitude, that when you take each other for granted, mm-hmm. and that's what was happening. Because my general here was a pastor in a certain church. Myself, I was employed. You know, I have a house up in the house, so what? I can work. And a paka.
Yes.
12. Uh-huh. Now, I and a fellowship up yes. to 11.
Mm-hmm.
You can, but we were running. It was a running session.
Yes.
It was a running season.
Yes.
And we learned that if you take each other for granted, there is no love.
Yes.
Upendo unaendanga ukipungua, ukipungua, ukipungua. Now it gets to a point whereby you don't care.
Yeah.
You relax. Mm-hmm. Unasema, nikulipiana nyumba, nikulea tu.
Yeah. And so when you start taking each other for granted,
mm-hmm.
this is where even temptations come.
Yes, comes in.
And you feel that you are lusting after other
women,
opposite sex.
Yeah, and men.
You feel like there are people who are investing time with you.
Yeah.
Because you took your relationship for granted.
For granted.
And so don't take each other for granted.
Mm.
Please value each other.
Yeah.
Add value to your relationship.
Encourage your spouse.
Encourage your spouse.
Mm.
I can see someone called Miriani Mwai saying, great job. I miss your teaching. Fiolela saying, I can see Jacinta Wanjiko saying, Guy, toiguere da. And I can see Jacinta again saying, passive. Now about communication, please. I can see Esther Wanjiko Karanja there saying, God bless you, servants, learning as we wait for our spouses.
Oh, yeah, they will come in Jesus' name. That time is coming, see.
And Sarah Mugwe there saying, haya, nekulia. And so don't take each other for granted.
Yes.
The way that you are serious when you are dating,
mm.
the way that you are serious mm. when you are proposing, when you are so serious planning for the wedding or the marriage night,
mm.
that same seriousness,
mm-hmm.
ingia nayo,
yeah.
jenganeni nayo,
mm-hmm.
because that is what will determine
mm-hmm.
your marriage to start, your marriage to make it,
mm-hmm.
because seriousness, whatever you invest in a relationship, garbage in, garbage out. Good investment, good returns.
Yes.
And so whatever you out input is what you output.
Yes.
And so this must be clear in any relationship
mm-hmm.
that you have to take responsibility.
And everybody yes. is responsible.
Yes.
Everybody is supposed to know.
Yes.
His or her part.
Yes.
Because we always see couples and we admire them.
Yes.
Let me tell you, how I could talk a Jew.
Yes.
Wakakuja huku chini,
mm-hmm.
they are now angels.
Yes.
No. For them to have that healthy relationship,
yes.
there was work that was done.
Yes.
Na hapo diyo tunapotelea.
Mm.
You don't want to labor.
Yes.
You don't want to pay that cost.
Yes.
Pay the cost if
yes.
you value
mm.
your relationship.
Yes.
If you value your relationship,
mm-hmm.
if you admire that couple that you see,
yes.
I can assure you and tell you, there is work
yes.
behind that
mm-hmm.
has been done.
Yes.
Investment has been done.
Sure.
So when we admire other people's relationship or marriages, not even you have your responsibility.
Yes.
Let's work on our pride
mm-hmm. mm-hmm. mm-hmm.
for us to be able to solve the mistakes
yep. mm-hmm.
and grow together
yes.
and go together.
Yes.
And our relationship
mm-hmm.
and our marriages mm-hmm. will stand.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Powerful, powerful, powerful. Let me hear from you. What are you saying out there? Timothy Miner saying, we bless God for your great teaching. Thank you. We thank the Lord together. Terry Kimani saying, we are learning from the best. I pray that the Lord will continue advancing us. Gilbert Langat saying, leo ni ile siku. Thanks, watumishi wa Mungu. I have learned a lot. Value each other. Encourage each other. God bless you so much. The time I will marry, I will call you on my wedding. Pastor Lea, hope you will come.
Oh, yeah.
I'm not sure whether you already have someone.
Yeah.
Lakini najua kuna watu
make sure I invite me with a card.
Yes,
yeah,
we are coming.
Yeah.
We are coming there, Gilbert Langat. The other mistake that we encountered is the mistake of handling our in-laws.
Yeah.
I would visit my sister and I would be there for a long time, as I
mm-hmm,
say.
Mm-hmm.
I would even go and buy something and do it. Mm-hmm. And my Geno here would proceed and go and do something, yes, with a sister-in-law or with the mother, and I am not aware.
Yeah.
So when we meet in the house,
Where are you?
Why couldn't we go to?
Is she not our mother?
Yes.
Then you were like, okay, she's our mother, but I'm so concerned. Yes. I'm her daughter. I have to go.
Yes.
Oh my goodness, have to go.
Yes.
Even I won't tell him.
Yes.
Ataniona tu jioni na maziwa na mahindi ya kuchemshwa. Umetoa wapi? Si nimekuwa usha go.
Yes.
I thought it was my responsibility, mm-hmm, to go without informing,
yes,
him. And you know, for me, I did not know it was a mistake. The same case applies to him. It's okay. I'm hanging out with my sister.
Yes.
Myself, I'm hanging out with my parents and my brothers. Mm. So there is no problem. But let me tell you, it was a problem.
Yeah.
Because whenever you go to visit, where's the enemy going to?
Yes.
Mm. You have to do something.
Yes.
Maybe you find a shopping. Yeah. Lazima waachie kitu, and maybe you had not agreed.
Yes.
What is going to happen?
Quarrels.
Brains
quarrels.
Now.
Yeah, and saying, it escalates to something like, I know you hate my mother.
Yes.
I know you don't like my sister.
Yeah.
And so there would be that particular quarreling and conversation. And, it would escalate to so much. And you are feeling like you hate each other. You don't want to see each other. Because I don't understand. Bona yeye anaenda. I remember one time you went and you came back and I was very offended. And so early in the morning, I just went and did shopping and left for home. Lakini bado ninasikia mvuko inaumia. But bona ninajiumiza. Sasa nikiwa huko ndio
ni revenge.
And so sasa nikifika home nasema asante hata umesaidia my mom. Anaongeza chumvi kwa ile kidonda. Ni asante kwa sababu kama singeenda jana wewe ungemkumbuka
ungeenda. You see those brain games?
And you find that
because of lack of alleging or kupanga vitu,
yes,
pamoja,
yes,
and agreeing,
yes,
on how are the in-laws,
yes,
supposed to be visited.
Yeah.
Let me tell you, it was a running. It really taught us a lot.
For sure.
That when you want to visit your sister,
yes,
when you want to visit your mom, now our mom,
yes,
we have to sit, agree, and decide on what we are supposed to do. On what we are supposed to carry as we go.
Yes.
So it was a running time.
Yes.
So now these days we can't do that.
Mm-hmm.
Now we are grown up.
Yeah. We've overcome it.
Yeah. We have
learned from it.
Of course. Mm-hmm. That was a mistake.
Yeah.
But it came to strengthen us.
Yeah.
And to show us how we are supposed to handle our in-laws.
Yes.
And I'm telling you, we learned.
Yeah.
I cannot visit. He cannot visit. Without informing or without plan.
Yeah, not that we are fearful or we really want to control each other.
No.
But that communication, that little communication.
The communication.
I feel like I want to go and see mom, so I'm rushing there for an hour.
Yeah.
Or if you call me and I'm out of network, it's because where mom lives, there is that shortage of network.
Mm-hmm.
And so just that information, Little information will take you long way.
Yeah.
And so I can see Diana Lucas saying, teach one day about marrying a mama's boy and how to deal with a difficult mother-in-law. That's a very wonderful discussion subject there. Dealing with mama's boy.
Yes.
That man who is married. Lakini bado anakula, anakaa, kila akiongea, ni mama,
yes, ni mama, mama
akishahara
ikiigia,
ni mama, thinking of mother, yes,
even
yes.
You don't know that you have a responsibility,
yes,
because when you get married, you become one,
yes.
Now you are not supposed to be told what you are supposed to do by your mother.
And it will be double tragedy.
Of course.
If it is mama's boy, and that mama-in-law is a difficult mama.
Oh, yeah.
I'm telling you, the lady out there, utaona kivumbi.
Yes.
But by the grace of God, we are here to unlock such serious messes.
And tell those men that are mama's boy.
Yes.
They need to work on that.
Yes.
Reason being, mm-hmm. the lady, whether the man make the mistake, the lady will always be blamed.
Yes.
That in way when buyer mm-hmm. compared to my son, yes. you don't respect my son.
Yes.
And maybe even the son doesn't respect you.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Do you see those blame games?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Even being a mama's boy can cause those blames.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. For sure. I can see Beth Kongo saying, paying cost. Powerful word there. I can see Samantha Andre saying, watching all the way from Limuru. Thank you, Samantha.
Mm-hmm.
And the final one that we would share is that we made a mistake of going to bed at different times. So I'm left here with my headset. I'm online. I'm just playing or watching on social media. I'm just there. My Jeno has left to go to bed, and I'm joining her 2 hours later. And yet I expect her to meet my expectations.
The fellowship. Lazima tutembee Jerusalem, mji wa Jerusalem.
Yes.
You can imagine.
Yes.
Ni umeenda umelala 2 hours. Yes. My Jeno here anakuja kulala. Yes. Do you think it will be peaceful?
Na unajua ulinipitisha desert nyingi sana.
Of course.
Because I'm coming with expectations, but the timing is wrong.
Yeah, I'm already asleep. I'm tired, nimelala. What do you do? You say no.
Yes.
And the thing is,
yes.
You see the blame is?
Yes.
Jifunze.
Yes.
Kujanga kwa kitanda mapema. Mm-hmm. Iyo kazi unafanya usiku.
Yes.
Sasa ni kukereleshana. Wacha yes. kufanya iyo kazi tena usiku. Mm-hmm. Usiku.
Na unagongwa na.
Yeah, na
there is a weapon.
Very painful. Yes.
A very natural yes. weapon with the ladies mm-hmm. from here.
Mm-hmm.
They strike you with this one. Yes. Angalia na huko. Lala.
Yeah.
Si ulikuwa huko. Si hizo si, social na, media. Yeah. Si hizo picha ujisai. And I know men, you can identify with how yeah. I am speaking. Whenever you are denied that particular time,
mm-hmm.
sleep haikujangi.
Mm.
Kwa hivyo unaenda masaa mengine kama mawili before your eyes can close.
Mm-hmm.
And so that has been and was a serious mistake.
Mistake.
But for now, we have tried our best.
Yes.
At least one of the promises that we are riding on as we celebrate our 11th anniversary.
Yes.
Ni kwamba we sleep together on time.
Yes.
We leave the table room together. We go to the bedroom yes. together. And we are at the same level.
Yes.
And then from that, how has it been?
It has been so nice.
Yes.
No complaint.
Yes.
Muji wa Jerusalem, it has been peaceful.
Yes.
It has been enjoyable.
Yes.
Because you are not being forced.
Yes.
Because when you are forced, even you don't enjoy.
Yeah. The game drives out there are just awesome.
Yeah.
And so I can see Mima Wangoi there saying, we really appreciate your teachings, watching together with my hubby all the way from Limuru. Yes, Mima, may the Lord bless your yes. relationship.
Yes.
So, you know, spend time together. Yes. Go to rest together.
Mm-hmm.
Don't be left there. Ukiwa na simu.
And if yes. you be left behind,
yes.
make sure that you are explaining to your Jeno.
Yes.
Kwa nini umeachwa?
Yes.
Is that thing, even if you don't yes. do it that
kama
night.
Kama uko na homework, unafanya yes. pengine, or you are studying.
What are
late.
The consequences?
Yes.
Are you a student?
Yes.
Is there something that you are doing at night?
Yes.
It has to be agreed.
Yes.
Not every time.
Yes.
That from Monday to Monday,
mm-hmm.
you go to bed
yes.
late.
Mm-hmm.
Even us women,
yes,
we need it.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody, we say Martinia, the man is the one who is in need of
yes.
mutakatifu.
Yes.
No. Both of us, we need it.
Mm-hmm.
And because both of us, we need it, it has to go on well, smoothly.
Yes.
How can it happen? You talk. Because communication is the key. Kwa nini unaachwa kwa table?
Yes.
Is there something sensible
yes,
that you are doing?
On. And I can tell you, men, that being a man, when you are left there on the couch, you are lying there and you are going through your headset or your social media accounts, likelihood to be tempted even to serve other sites like
yeah.
pornographic materials,
yeah.
they are very high.
They are very high.
You can be tempted even to text your ex.
Mm-hmm.
When your wife is in there,
yeah.
You can temptation usiku kwa sababu mawazo yametulia unaelekea kulala. Mm-hmm. You are driven
and devil
crazy.
Knows.
And devil knows, yeah. That way, and you can be tempted in so many ways. Mm-hmm. Na pia sio tu kuachwa kwa kiti. Even when you are in bed, and there you are still having your phone on.
Yeah.
You are still scrolling, and your wife is there, or your husband is,
yeah,
there. You are even receiving calls there when it is time, mm, to go to bed.
It is bedtime.
Please, it is bedtime.
Time.
Put your phones to silent,
yes,
mood.
Yes, don't receive the call.
Yes.
Let those people know. Let,
yes, that from 9 or from 10.
I don't pick.
Yes,
phone.
Unless it is emergency,
yeah,
and an emergency call, you can detect,
oh, yeah,
it, you can discern it.
Mm.
And so don't make this mistake,
yes,
of sleeping different times.
It because, can cause,
yes,
your marriage.
Because when your wife denies you,
mm-hmm,
even when you are waking up the following day, you hit that door with the temptation.
Yes.
Out there. In
and the desire. With
and the desire,
with that desire.
Even the judgment that,
yes,
you are making about your wife.
Mm-hmm.
You know, saying she doesn't care.
She's
even food. Even that breakfast, I will
sit
not take
kula,
it. You know, this thing
the
can generate all the heat
judgment
to bring,
yeah,
down your relationship.
Your relationship.
And so those are serious mistakes,
mm-hmm,
that we ever made,
mm-hmm,
in our relationship.
Yes.
Can we hear from you as we come to the close of our discussion about the 11 mistakes that we ever made in our marriage? After tomorrow, on 8th of August, we celebrate 11 years. You know how many days are those? It is more than 3,650 days. Uongeze zingine, 365. So we are above there, going to almost 4,000 plus days together.
Yes.
You can make it, my sister. Mm. You can make it, my brother. And I want to make a prayer together with you tonight. Our Father and our God,
oh,
in,
yes,
the name,
Lord,
of Jesus Christ.
Yes, Jesus.
How I pray that marriages will stick together.
Yes.
How I pray that relationships will stick together.
Yes,
how,
Lord,
I pray that the singles will be able to make it in the mighty name of the Lord.
Yes.
Almighty God, you have brought us this far, 11 years.
Yes.
And oh God, we look forward to so many calendars,
yes,
together,
Lord,
because,
yes,
it is you who ordained our marriage.
Mm-hmm.
You are the Lord who others marriages, my Father.
Yes.
I speak to relationships,
mm-hmm,
out there.
Yes.
I speak to individuals out there.
Yes.
I speak to families out there.
Yes,
that Almighty God, they are partaking this grace,
mm-hmm,
the anointing that has kept us together.
Yes.
We are sharing it now in the mighty name
of
the
Jesus,
Lord. The mistakes that we have made in our,
yes,
relationship.
Yes.
Oh God, the friends are learning from them,
yes,
and they are not any more victims of the same,
yes,
because,
Lord,
you are going to make them better in the name of the Lord.
Yes.
If there is a struggling relationship right now,
yes,
fix stability in the mighty name of the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
If there is any family that has broken up, I pray that you are reconciling,
oh,
them in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Mm-hmm.
If there is a single person in a relationship right now, that relationship is working in the mighty name of the Lord,
yes,
and you are with your people,
mm-hmm,
in the mighty name of Jesus,
Jesus
Christ.
Name,
bless
God,
your people, Jehovah.
Yes.
Establish marriages, establish,
yes,
relationships,
yes,
establish families in the mighty name of,
in
Jesus,
Jesus
Christ. Lord, from this side,
mm-hmm,
where you have blessed us with 11 years,
yes,
of fullness of God,
mm-hmm,
full presence of Jehovah with us,
mm-hmm,
as your servant, we speak the blessing of God.
Yes.
We prophesy,
yes,
we speak,
Lord,
prophetically,
yes,
that these marriages we hold,
oh,
together.
Hold
Langat
together
said that he is going to do a wedding and he will be happily married.
Yes,
we,
Lord,
pray that it will happen.
It will happen,
Jehovah,
and
God.
It will
my
happen,
Father,
in
my
Jesus
God,
name.
Everything that is written here,
yes,
everything that, oh God, the dear ones are contemplating in their minds,
yes,
lead them in the direction,
mm,
of holding together,
yes,
and that they are blessed of the Lord.
Mm.
Father, bless relationships and lead these people to a point of even canceling others,
yes,
and even, oh God, dispensing,
yes,
the love that, mm-hmm, is found in relationship, dispensing,
yes,
advices,
mm-hmm,
that is coming from experience and,
mm-hmm,
good experience,
yes,
in their relationship.
Hallelujah,
this is
Jesus,
our prayer during our anniversary,
mm-hmm,
to all these relationships,
oh, yes,
in Jesus' name. bless them. Amen. 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 May the Lord God bless you. What is your parting shot, even as we wait for the 8th of August?
This is what I will say. Learn to discuss your mistake.
Yes.
Because if you don't discuss them, they can develop to be problems. Learn to discuss your mistakes. Because if you don't discuss them, they will develop to become a problem.
Yes.
Number two, be open to each other.
Yes.
And when you make a mistake, kindly accept. If you are required to say sorry, say sorry.
Yes.
If you are required to ask for forgiveness, do it. If you value your relationship, it is okay to do a mistake in marriages, but learn to handle them together, and together you can overcome.
Yes,
we have done it, and we are telling you from the deep of our hearts that after learning our mistake, solving them together, going for dates, do catch-ups, do dates. It's not a must that you go to those big hotels,
expensive sites.
No. Go somewhere that you can talk and discuss your issues.
Yes.
And after discussing your issues, you'll come up with a solution.
Amen.
So when you make a mistake, don't ignore.
Yes.
Don't ignore. Don't be proud. Be humble and be ready to be corrected where you have made a mistake.
For sure.
Yeah.
And so I can see Shiko Awili saying, Woy, I'm guilty as I watch. I'm following while in the bed and by Amelala 444. So Shiko, time is coming. And you will share in the morning. Yeah. Try to encourage him that he can be catching up with us every Tuesday. We have Joseph Washira saying, today is powerful. Wabo Gracia saying, you nailed it and I have learned a lot. And this is your question from Philly David. Mom, umewai toroka.
Philis, let me answer you. I have never. Sijawai toroka.
Na ulipotoroka, ulitoroka kwa mikaingia kwa mikono yangu.
Nikaingia kwa mikono ya marijangia. The reason of not running away ama kutoroka.
Yes.
It is when I realized,
yeah,
or we realized,
yes,
that this is our relationship and it has to work.
Yes.
And we have to solve our problems and our differences.
Yes.
Because kutoroka sio solution.
Yes.
Kwani utorokee shida? Ukitoroka doesn't mean shida imeisha. Actually, umeleta shida mingi. Because they are parents wa bwana watakuja, the parents of the wife watakuja. Now you start exposing yourself in a kuwa case. Failures, sijawai toroka.
Yes.
Not that I couldn't be able to do it. I couldn't be able to do it. Nigetoroka, but you know what? The thing is, value your relationship.
Value your relationship. So, ata mimi file sijawai toroka.
Yes.
So, and I thank the Lord even for these 11 years. Gilbert Langat saying, hakuna kulala mpaka tumalize wote hii mkutano. Fioela Juliet anasema amen. Mima Wangoi there saying, very true, mom. Discussion of mistakes rather than keeping it in your heart. Jose Washida there saying amen. And so we can talk and talk and talk. But there comes a time that we must look for another day. Every Tuesday we are here. So I'm asking all the followers and the viewers, please like our page, Pastor Kinyanjui Joseph.
Yes.
That is the page that we stream from. You know, like it. If you have a question, if you have a proposal, like what we had here that we need to discuss about the mama's boy and a very difficult mother-in-law, we have started a WhatsApp group. Kwa hivyo kuna namba ambayo ina crawl pale, utaweza kuitumia, na hiyo namba tuna form a WhatsApp group, au unaweza kutuma jina, group, andika tu group,
yes.
Alafu tutaweza kuku upload pale. You are able to suggest or even to connect with us at a better personal level,
yes.
Na tunaweza kudiscuss further about it. Na Mungu awabariki. Kesho, remember we are praying for 72 hours. Tomorrow is another day that we are going to pray for,
yes,
our marriages, our families.
Yes, you can, your marriage.
Yeah, you, yeah, can join us on lunch hour time. We are live on the same page from 1 p.m. to 1:45 p.m. Then in the evening, we shall be live here again. We shall be streaming from Mount Kenya TV. Mount Kenya TV is hosting us from 10 p.m. to 11 midnight. And so we shall be there. Actually, we will be there from 11 p.m. 10 p.m. will be in the studio. 11 p.m. all the way to midnight, we will have a session even to pray for marriages and,
yes,
even to share the word of the Lord. So join us tomorrow from Mount Kenya TV. We shall be streaming from the same page. So like the page. You know, invite people to like, because when your bio likes and when your hubby likes the page, we are able to read together from the same script. And who knows, your marriage just needs that injection and your life will never be the same again.
Amen.
May the Lord God bless you.
Amen.
There is no better way than concluding with this song from Washira. And I know God will bless you. May the Lord God bless you.
Yes.
Have a good night.
Yes.
And may your marriage work.
Mm-hmm.
The singles,
yes,
our Lord is coming. You,
yes,
are blessed.
In Jesus'
God bless.
Name.
Good night.
Amen.
Happy marriages.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. We are coming back again. Ibi mwe Israeli intura inene a Samaria kwa igetu wako ingwa onyodo wa mwimo wa mangu alomea na makeonekana maru alete murimosho magekio jaya intura ke ingwa ine kwa lanta ine ele male ke ingwa ine makiu gamati gukwiro Oh,